happy as a dream. Along came a fishing and to catch a fish or two. And the frog said, "Ribbit, how do you do?" "Well, shh," said the fisherman, "I want to catch a fish. If you croak too loud, I'll never get my wish." "Is that so?" the frog said to the man. And he croaked a little louder, said, "Do you know who I am? I'm the greatest frog living in the land." He puffed out his chest and he started to expand. Said the fisherman, "To me you're just a frog, no more than a tadpole or a polywog." "Shh," said the fisherman, "I wanna catch a fish. If you croak too loud, I'll never get my wish." "Is that so?" the frog said to the man. And he croaked even louder, said, "Do you know who I am? I'm the fastest frog that you've ever seen. I know all the fish and just swimming in the stream. I can catch a mosquito, a ladybug, or fly faster than you or the blinking of an eye." "Now shh," said the fisherman, "I want to catch a fish. If you croak too loud, I'll never get my wish." "Is that so?" the frog said to the man. And he croaked even louder, said, "Do you know who I am?" By this time the frog got so upset, he croaked and fell to the fisherman's neck. "Gotcha," said the fisherman, "put him in a pail with a lid on top." And down the stream he sailed.
"Ribbit,